Doing more story with Mask of Truth. End of battle. Alright, let us continue the story. This is... Our group stops, awed by the sight before us. The expanse in front of them seems something from another world. We're clearly inside a structure. Yet there is a clear sky overhead, and flowers bloom in the glass below, their scent on the wind. Hey now, welcome! How's the sound quality? I decided to mess the gain a little as well, so... Hopefully it still sounds okay. When did we reach the outside? No. It only seems like we're outside, but the sky feels a little too, low. Yeah, it's all cramped in here. That's correct. We've descended from our original location. There's no logical way we could have gone outside. Oh, pits. Okay, the waves are a bit more prominent. Oh, pits, am I drunk again? I don't even remember drinking any booze this time. From what I can make sense of, this is all below the mausoleum. My liege, were you aware of this place? No! I had no idea. I was not even told that there was such a hidden sanctum in the mausoleum. I imagine they're the garden of some kind, created with the knowledge of the unbeaten Kayan. Created? You mean all this is someone's work? But how? I have no clue how he did it. But this is the Great Mikado we're talking about. I'm not surprised. True. After all, he did craft a great breach on Inaba in one day. Such a bright paradise all underground. I'm not dreaming, am I? I have a difficult time believing my eyes as well. To think a forest like this could exist underground. It's simply amazing. What's up? WTF, what do you mean? I suppose they can't help it. It's an incredible sight. But we've got a job to do. He built that shit. Yes, he built that shit. And he built that giant ass bridge in a day. Technology! We must hurry on. Oshitar, wait! Boss! It is dangerous to act alone. Please wait, we shall lead the way. I ignore the calls of the others striding ahead when I arrived in the familiar clearing. You are still alive, Zen. They actually defeated all those Guntadars? Golden Day and Extraordinary Day, yep. All that means is we'll be their next opponents. You will go no further. We shall sacrifice all for our master. Out of my way. I have no business with you. The Yatana Waribe all ready themselves for battle. I draw my bladed fan in response. We finally caught up. These guys are. It seems that they are intent on a confrontation. Well, I suppose this was bound to happen. Very well. You shall have your fight. As everyone bursts in, they ready their weapons as well. Please, stay your hands. But they all fall silent, the figure that appears before us. Monika, thank goodness, she is safe. You are all honored guests of the Mikado. It will pain his heart to see any of you injured. Monika? What are you doing here? Your Highness, it has been quite a while. What is the meaning of all this? Where have you been all this time? Well, clearly here. Thought it was iron. Oh, it was an iron fan, but it has edges for blades. And poisoned grooves, too. It's a... Twisted weapon. Monika! Ooh, Mikado's last words gone bad. Monika only pulls Anju's clothes in a close and gentle embrace. Though bewildered by her lack of response, Anju soon calms, relaxing against her. After a quiet moment, Hanako lets go, kneeling to eye level of Anju. There is much that must be told to you, Your Highness. Yet I fear it is not my place to explain it all to you. What do you mean by that? You must tell me all that has happened. The duty belongs to another. one behind here, who has been waiting for the day he may see you again. What? Impossible, are you saying? I told you, he speaks even beyond death. Father? Is my father here? What? A sudden shockwave rocks the clearing and the ground begins to tremble. What's going on? Hey, look over there. What in the... We can't see much of the structure, but what we can see, it looks like it's crumbling to the ground. But it's not simply collapsing. The exterior morphs and shifts with each breath. It's Mikazuchi voiced by Dio. I don't believe so. That doesn't seem to sound like Dio's voice. I have to look it up. But it's becoming a new structure entirely. Everyone stares, and it would tear their eyes with the transformation. Hanako pales, and her voice is quiet as she murmurs. So it's begun, my lord. Hanako. With that, Hanako disappears. Looking at it right now, go for it. I was trying to look it up on the fly, but you better do it, Hanako. It disappears into the ever-changing building and fades from sight. The Yatanawarebe all nod to each other and follow her. Let's go, Oshitor. Right. We head into the building and follow a long path to a large open area. Almost as if waiting for our arrival, projected images suddenly flicker in the air. Ooh. Future. These are. Everyone, look. What are my liege, be careful. What a mysterious sight. Moving mare and carriage? But I see no steeds carrying and pulling it. A metal bird? Does a bird make so loud a sound when it flies? No, look closely. The sides are lined with those glass windows. Do you suppose it's some kind of vessel for transport as well? Is it an airship of some sort? Even bigger than Papa's ship. Nope, but they sound just like him. Ah. Whoa, it's huge! What are all those long, huge pillars? They're supposed to be houses or something. Like the ruins of the Onkami Yonkai. But there's something different about it. Such heights. They're as tall as the mausoleum. And you see so many of them in those orderly lines. What manner of city is this? Ooh, you can make out the hexes. What exactly is all this? Images of the past, long ago. Back when humans... The future keeper. Where the still dominant civilization on this planet. The future. It is hard for the people today to imagine how common a sight this was. Could these be memories of the Onvian Takayan? And well, the past, yes. You can tell, Koan. Yes, it might be the tales my mother would tell me when I was a child, I think. Joy of people reach here. Eventually. I've heard these stories as well. I never imagined such amazing sights. Everyone gave around the area in wonder, an eerie laugh echoes throughout the chamber. That is, where was to see the source of the laughter? There, standing on a platform in the middle of the room, Mutis gazes dreamily at the ethereal images before us. His face is a portrait of utter ecstasy. He doesn't even seem to notice our presence. Ah, magnificent. What a splendid sight. Oh, the glorious secrets of the unbeaten Kaien. Oh my. With this much technology, I may stand equal to the Mikado. No. I will be able to accomplish even greater feats, bro. How the fuck? Yes. I shall surpass even the Mikado. I shall be the one to lead this country. No, this world. Bruh, you ain't gonna be able to do shit with it. Yeah, it's like owning a smartphone or a computer when you're computer illiterate. You're gonna get to a point, but he's still sprouting the stuff. Udith, why do you not see? This world does not need any of these relics of the past. Udith finally shifts his gaze to us. My, still alive after all. You have a convenient knack for self-preservation. Quite a nuisance, really. I suppose I can forgive that. After all, you came all this way to witness the birth of my reign over this world. Yeah, this world is still beautiful about it. Right? Or perhaps you've come to congratulate me. He looks down at us with a smile. The sight of us seems to aspirate him more than anything else. What? Behold, the arts of the gods. The infinite knowledge kept by those known and unbeaten Kaien. All of it. Now mine. Yes, not yours, but rightfully mine. The legacy of the unbeaten Kaien. Oh, hey, Julie! We had tech up to a time and kept the theater look. Hey, Julie, welcome! Thanks for popping in! I know it's quite late for you, though. So grateful when you showed up. Hello. Well, this Wutis turns his gaze to the back of the room. Oh, thank you for the follow. Can't sleep. One of those days. Welcome to a near slightly younger. Well, technically older. I'm pretty sure. Well, then again. I'm pretty sure it came. That's the question there. I want to say Uta, the original Uta came out before the first Nier. I want to say. Almost 6 a.m. Oh, damn. Early for you, huh? It came because of Ooge. That it is, but you know. Timing is still timing, after all. And you will watch from your coffin all for all eternity. At the end of his gaze sits the transparent container, the Mikado's life pod. Looks like Wutis has complete control over the Mikado's life now. That is... What? The previous Mikado? Then he was still alive. So he was. He's a man greater than I've ever known. It pains me to see him in such a state. Everyone stares at the Mikado. Yeah, I get that too. Speechless, Anju takes a shaky step forward. It's alright. It is alright now. Yeah, fucking insomnia. You got those days. Father. Anju runs to the life pod, drawing her arms around the glass casing and clinging desperately. Father. Father. Thank goodness. You are still alive. Alive is a strong term. He seems to be very much on borrowed time, my man. Anju, no apology of mine can ever be enough. I've caused you much sorrow. Anju weeps, hugging the glass as if to reach her father on the other side. He smiles gently, looking down at her from within the casing. You have done well to reclaim the Imperial Capital. How you have matured. You must stand proud. What are you crying here for? You are the Mikado of Yamato, are you not? But it's not by my strength alone. It was because of Ushtar and everyone else. It was all by their aid. You need not be modest. You would not have their aid if you had not proven yourself a Mikado worthy of their trust. I am truly proud to call you my daughter. Aww. Thank goodness the two of them could. Finally, the two Mikados are together again. It is a beautiful sight. Yes, indeed. It really, truly is. Apply to make up the 10,000 tutorials. Ooh. Ooh, maybe. Yes. Yes, marvelous. I'm sure we are quite touched. Considered my heart things appropriately touched. We're plucked. On Twitter. Her atmosphere is broken by a condescending jeer. Plenty of lady here. Oh yeah, no, it's a veritable harem scenario right now. I've turned to see Wutis holding back laughter. Wutis, is this a joke to you? Perish the thought. I'm merely giving them my blessing. It's quite a touching reunion of parent and child. Everybody has to, you know, picks up things at different speeds. A suitable opening, I expect, for the events to come. Have you forgotten not only your loyalty, but your compassion as a person? Compassion as a... Wait till she used the fumarill, Julie. Compassion leather. Ah, I see. I've forgotten that you vessels still get attached to those notions. But I would rather not have you compare me to proxies like yourselves. Still, I won't exist. It's a trivial matter to me. Fumarill is everything. If she pops up, you'll know who she is. You'll see, like a cricket chip on the edge of hearing. More importantly, I have words for you. Or that will just focus on me. I'm disappointed in you, most of all. You were the one that chosen, but you wasted your gifts, choosing instead to play amongst the proxies. Why? Why do you never think to put your abilities and your luck to good use? Try as I might, I cannot understand it. It seems your foolishness knows no bounds. We may never come to an understanding. Then answer me this. Why are you so obsessed with this legacy? My brother intended for me to inherit the legacy of the past civilization. But to be honest, I could care less. Civilization thrives because its people keep building upon it. Who wants to be saddled with a relic of the past? Not to mention how dangerous it would be to give people more power than they can handle. Fumi is the full package. You'll understand if Fumi shows up. She should pop up. She's one of the main characters. This man should know all about these mistakes of the past, yet why? I could tell he feels some kind of rivalry for me. Was that all there is to it? Ortis. Having pulled back from the transparent casing, Anju now stands a regal poise as she glared at Ortis. I do not care for your insolent boasts. You talk of things far beyond your station, and we will speak no more of this. However, I will not allow the likes of you to insult my father or Oshitor. Wrong. You are wrong. Ortis barely gives the enraged Anju a passing glance, shaking his head. And even still, you sprout this drivel. I suppose that is your role. No, to distract while a more noble being takes the fore. You are a decoy, nothing more than a sacrifice. Decoy, what exactly are you talking about? Such insolence. Face me with this. I am not finished with. Oh, be silent, damn puppet. Who do you think you're talking to? It's one of those things. I personally am way too lazy to figure out makeup. Learning female stuff. It's one of those. Well, as a guy, I never really had to really take care of myself, and I'm quite the bum, so it's like, eh. Going to a therapist after all. Ah. Well, small steps now. You'll figure it out one day. What? Now I will speak and you will listen. The word of this world's rightful sovereign. My name is Wutus. I am the true-born son of the Mikado and the rightful heir. I am the Onbitan Kaiyan itself. And you, imprudent proxies, will kneel before your master. At his word, the Yata Warebe kneel respectfully, but they are not the only ones. What? My body just moved on its own. What? Everybody, different stokes, different folks. You'll find something. They had all taking a knee too? Got one of those things. Well. No, what's gone into us? Is this another one of its tricks? Some form of hypnosis? No, it is not a matter of overpowering us. Felt like instinct. Like we had no choice. Humanity. That's power. Just from his commands alone, it cannot be. The designs of how these characters are. Cannot be. The same as the last Mikado? Here is Fumarill. So that man is truly an Onbitan Kaiyan. There you go. That's Fumarill. Actually, if you had a game, there's so many cute other chicken things. Master. We are so sorry. Crying out in shock and defiance, everyone kneels and bows their head to Wutsis. everyone but Korn, Anju, and I. Look at that makeup. What the? You. Korn seems to realize that skin. Realize something as she glares at Wutus. Not fair. Some characters are just made to be beautiful, my man. Correct. All of you may remain kneeling for now. The rest of this conversation is not for primitive minds anyway. You mean to say you are a child of my father's? And his successor? Then, that would make us... But even if that were true, why was I not aware of such... Well, it's a simple answer. Why not ask the Mikado? After all, here he lies, right in front of you. Father? The Mikado clearly hears Anju as she turns to him, but he remains silent. It can't be. Still, under the circumstances, it seems only natural that one in your position wouldn't be told the truth. You were but a puppet. Your entire existence is a stage play performed to keep the country of Yamato peaceful and distracted. And what of it? Indeed, perhaps I exist for the sole purpose of uniting Yamato's people. Yet that is a role I will gladly take pride in. You have no right to call me a mere puppet. They do say that ignorance is a sin. If so, you must be the most sinful creature I've ever met. Really, the depth of it almost inspired pity. Wutus, how dare you insult our... You can go through the playlist of the second game. Ah! I was like, wait, who is he plugging in my channel? Better be me. I believe I said remain kneeling. Why can't I? Outraged, Munichika rises up and attempts to bolt towards Wutus, but a casual reprimand from him is all it takes to freeze her in place. Seems cruel, but I suppose I have no other option. Well then, allow me to reveal to you the truth of your purpose. Please stop. Last, Mikado speaks in a desperate attempt to silence Wutus. However, he ignores the weak plea and moves on. True, your role was to unite the people and lead them. You are a being created to rule. In that, at least, you are not mistaken. The Mikado worried that his passing will leave a power struggle. To avoid such a scenario, he created an heir, that is to say, you. And what exactly is your point? Surely you must see that this alone would only create an inadequate successor. What? A world is maintained through ancient hearts. The knowledge of the Onvi Tenkaian is a keystone that supports it. Thus, someone who lacked the ancient knowledge would not be able to correct the flaws in our world. They could never be a true successor. Yet, you were never told. Why is that, I wonder? Why would they let you go on, oblivious to the ancient knowledge that rested here? That is... But the answer is simple, isn't it? It's because you are a puppet, nothing more. And a hollow puppet is the easiest to manipulate. Wow. It requires no competence, no intelligence. All you needed to be was an empty-headed little princess. To nod and smile. That was your role. That is enough from you. How dare you continue to insult me? Did I miss anything, father? Anju flinches at Wutus' words. She slowly rises to look back at her father, the Mikado. Oh, thank you for watching then. Glad I managed to make it. It's like it's a good record with fear in her eyes. Father. Anju. Am I just a mere puppet? A replacement for you? That merely sits up top the throne? Ooh, boy. Anju, you got some complicated background. No, that is not true. I've never thought of you as a puppet. Not once. Right? Being a clone of his daughter probably makes things a bit awkward. Not true. What exactly do you... Oh, I see. You haven't even told her about that. About what? Anju, he hasn't told you the true reason you exist. He knows. Were you aware? Long before the proxies were ever born, in the age of the Onvi Tenkaian's reign, the Mikado had a daughter. It seems the Mikado loved his daughter very much, a veritable apple of his eye. The Mikado missed her terribly after he lost her. It is fucking going in. Though when tasks were creating air, a most interesting idea occurred to him. Otis, stop. You. Please stop. Otis grins proudly, telling the pleading voice behind him. That's right. The Mikado created an heiress based off his original daughter. His true daughter. You understand now, don't you? That was you, Anju. You are a facsimile, a literal proxy for the child he actually loved. That affair. Father can be quite a cruel man. I suppose all the love he's shown you was never actually meant for you in the end. Oh. So essentially, Julie, is that scientist loses daughter. Scientist deeply misses daughter. Scientist has daughter's DNA. Scientist makes clone. Told you this Mikado was scum. No, I can sympathize. You know? If losing a relative forever and you had the means to clone them, I don't know. I don't think I would be that strong. It's a lie. Jeez. You see now? If you are a puppet, there's time you acted like it. You will dance upon your stage again, but now I will pull your strings. Anju stands frozen in shock, struck dumb by despair. Wouldn't be the same, Blue. They wouldn't. But, you know what? I'll eventually realize that, such as the philosophy. I won't know that, but to have something familiar. Thousands of years in the future. Who knows? Maybe that will be just a little bit comforting. For that is your fate. You will follow my orders, for that I am your elder brother and a true successor to the Mikado. As long as you do so, I promise you this nation of Yamato will flourish even further under my rule. Do you not also wish for Yamato's prosperity? We can make that wish come true together. Yamato's prosperity. Now, Anju, take my hand. Your brother's hand. Brother. Anju weakly extends her hand to Otis. I have heard enough. I draw my metal phantom stand before Anju to shield her. And what is this? I will not let you have our liege. What's that supposed to mean? Ah, the ship of Theseus. Ah, that one. Will it be an entire different person? Anju. She needs time to absorb, but have faith. Anju will prevail. Ushtar, all this talk of the Onzian Kaien legacies. Right. None of it matters. I point my metal fan towards Wutus as I proclaim. Even without your help, our liege can bring prosperity to Yamato. And lastly, above all else, I despise you. Oh. Wutus' eyes narrow to slits. Good. That expression suits you. Quite striking. I suppose my father didn't choose you as his true successor for nothing. No. Huh? Oshitori's father's... What are you saying? Oshitori, eh? Even now you resist with this. Does nothing about him seem strange to you? What are you trying to say? You have been at his side all this time. You have shared so much of yourself with him. And you still haven't realized? Oshitori is. But that's... Oh, judging from your expression, you have at least had your suspicions. They are correct. The man who stands with you. His true name is... Be silent, Your Highness. It's Anju. Anju's scream echoes through the room. A silence falls, with none of us not sure how to respond. However, a dignified voice breaks the hush. I have no idea what you're talking about, I think. What? That's right, the boss is our boss, and no one else. Ain't that right? At Jackwell's words, everyone seems to snap back, defiant gaze turned to Wutus. Precisely. Well, that sounds about right. The man before us is the High Commander of Yamato, Sir Oshitori. The man we put our faith in. I will not let such insult to my brother stand. Who cares about that complicated stuff? Oshitori, and that's it. Isn't that right, Kuririn? matters not if Oshitora's inherited some other duty. He stands for the same righteous cause. High Commander of Yamato, eh? Damn right. This man is my greatest friend, and my one true rival, Oshitor. I could never mistake him. Dear sister, everyone, all of you, rest assured, my liege. I, Oshitor, swear to you now, my heart is unchanged. I shall stay by your side, as I always have, now and forever onward. Tears flow freely down Anju's face as she grasps my sleeve. I gently rest my hand against her back in a reassuring answer. My leash. Well, that only seems natural. Now she's lost all else. She can only cling to the illusion Oshitor she once loved. Wow, she is such a shithead. Lutus. Villain. I face Lutus one more, moving the stand between him and Anju. Now you have said your piece. I hope you are prepared for the consequences. Lutus is going in. With those words, I ready my weapon. No need to be so hasty. Before we get to that, I believe I have an obligation. A suitable reward to show guests who've come all this way in my honor. Do you not wish to see a demonstration of the power I attained? Allow me to show you a portion of it. That is... Just like a branch I broke off in the garden a little while ago. Observe, this is the true power of the Onbitan Kaien. As if reacting to his words, the branch in his hand bloomed with flowers, which bud and swell with plump, luscious fruits. Oh dear. Oh, this is hardly surprising. A trifle, really, compared to what I can really do. Did a simple genetic analysis of the plant, followed by rapid stimulation of the meritus stems to trigger oregonogenesis. And so you can see. What language is speaking now? I'm not sure. And next. Lutus' gaze turns towards the Mikado. Let me see. Perhaps I can rid my father of the worries that plagued him for so many years. Worries that plagued him? Yes, worries for our brethren, the Onbitan Kaien. I shall release them from the internal pain they have endured. You can't mean. For even that is within my power. Yes, I have acquired power even beyond yours. I, Lutus. As a response to his declaration, the lights mount in the wall and floors begin shifting new places. A square screen is revealed in one of the walls, and an image. Oh, this dude seems like a shit. He is a massive shit. Fuck it to life. A view of another location. Behold, humanity. Are those all Tatari? They're huge. Riluti covers her mouth as if to be sick. My, quite a collection of them. What a sad plight. Quarantine in a cage like this. I'm surprised he is allowing this. He's kind of stuck in a thing. But now everything will be alright. What is that? That is humanity in this story. There's magic involved, and humanity was cursed. Now you shall all be freed from Utsu Nemitya's curse. You shall be in peace. Now, Master Key. Grant me this wish, right? At the moment, Wutif is in complete control of the entire facility thanks to the Master Key. Humanity. If you watch the first game, you will know the backstory. Just know that humanity. Oh yeah, humanity fucked up. As Wutif raises the Master Key high, a weak voice interrupts him. No, you must stop this, Wutif. Slowly, Wutif turns to face its source once more. Wano. Why? Why do you... Like big time. Why do you not wish to save them? Is that not what you long for all these years? You are correct. The Mikado nods softly. I want the freedom. I want to give them peace from their tortured immortal forms. For so long, I sought only to accomplish that. That was why I sought the Master Key in the first place. I believe if all the mausoleum's functions were restored, I could. I only want to accomplish this in your stead, to finish your work. Why does this make you so unhappy? Unhappy? No. That is not it. It's simply an impossible thing for you. You do not have the right to inherit a legacy. Man. Just say it straight. This again. Nothing but excuses, just so you can pathetically cling to your past. The past of God. The Mikado, the coward. Silence envelops the room after which is a scream. After the echo fades, the room is quiet and the Mikado speaks once more. Perhaps you are right. With this you cling to, homie. He is, brother. Those creatures are my past. Whatever they may look like now, they were the same people. I lived alongside in the tide of humanity. Destroying them would be the same as destroying any hope of regaining the past. I could not bring myself to end them. They lived by my selfishness alone, and I knew it. That was precisely why I wished for the arrival of one to inherit this duty. And you tell me that he is the one? Tell me, how am I inferior to him in any way? My intellect is far beyond his. His conviction is no more than mine. So why? Why are you so obsessed with him? Why? Because I care deeply for you, Iwotus. Please. You must understand. All the relics in this mausoleum are yours now. You may have them. Please, I beg only one thing in return. Do not go through with this. Even now you give me this drivel. I am a human being, not a child in your dollhouse. Lotus. Very well, then bear witness to this. Watch as I finally accomplished what you never had the power to. I am Mutis, the inheritor of the Onvitankayan's knowledge, and the legacy of their name. I order you, grant a peaceful death to these remnants of the past. Release them from their purgatory. Order confirmed. Restraints temporary disengaged. Searching. Scanning target's oscillation frequency signature. At his words, the light intensifies. More and more lights flicking on along the walls. Mutis, stop Mutis at once. Do not let him use the master key. Bro, he's terrified. Something really bad's coming, worse than anything before. Stop, Wutus! I start towards Wutus, but the Yatanawarabe immediately moved to block my path, shooting him. We will not allow you out of my way. I do have time to deal with you. You may not, but we certainly do. We will not let anyone interfere, as Lord Wutus finally agrees with one wish. Sicilia, why are you simply standing there? Hurry and protect our master. Mutis, the Mikado's begging you. There has to be a reason behind it. Can we not talk this over further? We must discover his true intent. Are you that concerned about it? Or is it merely frustration that you lost to me? I'm afraid it's too late either way. Now, the verdict. Can we eliminate all of them? Analysis complete. Displaying target oscillation frequency signature. What is this strange pattern? Is this some kind of spell? Or was it one of those villains? Yep. This Eld script? Hey Kuon, can you read all this? That would be a little difficult for me, I think. Eradication variable. Warning, eradication process will require all systems to run the specifications above safety standards. Please disengage limiters on particle oscillation wave emitter before proceeding. Marvelous. To think they can even destroy those beings, as simply as that. Stop just now, Wutus! Very well, I order you, in the name of Wutus, unleash all your power, and bring eternal peace to these beings. What's going on? Why is anything happening? We all wait in silence until finally the system responds. Error. User lacks administrator privileges. Order. Cannot be completed. Oh dear. What did you say? For a moment, Wutus seems paralyzed in place. Why? Why? Once more, I order you in the name of Wutus. Unleash all your powers. Destroy them all. In this instant. Error. User lacks administrative privileges. Order cannot be completed. Please confirm administrative rights. I repeat. Wutus clenches fist, a howl of mad rage tearing from his throat. His commands were denied? Does that mean Wutus is? I lack administrative rights. He wants me to confirm my right. Oh, he's gonna end them from the internal pain. This goddamn worthless fossil! The system has responded to me as the bearer of the master key, so why? What is the matter now? Answer me! User identified as a clone. Under regulations, administrative rights have been restricted to level 4 access. And there it is. The Mikado was too much of a coward to tell him his son was a clone. Wait. One moment. What did you just say? A user identified as a clone. Under regulations, administrative rights have been restricted to level 4 access. He decided to have a son in this world, but he did not have a mother figure to do so, so he cloned himself to have another member of humanity. 1,000 years of loneliness does things to you, you know? A clone? What are you talking about? I am Wutus. I'm the rightful heir to your administrator. The Mikado, what is this nonsense, you? Now reionizing user's genetic code. It's good. Particle sequencer activated. Beginning dynamic scan. Nuclear genome. Mitochondrial genome. Base sequence confirmed. Multiple primer and homology scan complete. 99.9999999999% match. User identified as a clone of the registered administrator. There it is. So that's what it was. That's why he could never inherit the legacy. He just never wanted him to know about it. A clone? Who just physically recoils. He takes a step back, feet unsteady. Due to protocol, administrator access denied to clone users, exception. Current user granted level 4 permissions by registered administrator. Oh, so he actually tried. In case this ever happened. Sub-administrator users can determine maintenance operations and operate the sizes within safety parameters. But he was. So this is why my brother wanted to stop him. It's a lie. What's this? Life. All functions and systems at normal capacity. You lie! Wutus collapsed on the ground like a marionette with strings cut. Oh, Wutus. This was. I will hope you never find out. Wow, so dark. Well, to be fair, the Mikado is the person there. He made a clone of himself to treat as a son. He had science, so much science. They created all the characters with animal ears, as you can see, of the cast. The whole cast is primarily of animal people who are the next step in humanity, so to speak. So they can make people from basically nothing. And they created an entire race, subspecies, and cultures that were able to clone on the surface. Because humanity is clone. No, he's still human. It's just that the person, the antagonist right now, is his son. Yes, I told you, you cannot. For you were never born due to conventional meiosis, but I'm sorry. I am so sorry, Wutus. I am evil. Impossible. Then I am. Wutus mutters an awe. Inaudibly to himself, as if delirious. This cannot be happening. I'm the one who carries the blood of the Onvitankayan. I'm the very light that will illuminate this land. Oh yeah, the backstory is very dense. Morally yikes, but at the same time, you know what? It's very human. There's like only, what, two humans right now in this very room? The whole cast were created. And descendants of creations. Nah, that's just very selfish. It is, but at the same time, if you were spent hundreds of years by yourself with no other humans, who knows? The rest of us stand there as well at a loss for words. Oshitori, what do we do? I mean, even he appears that the cluster is expanding. After the warning alarm repeats a couple times, the ear spinks. Screech echoes across the room. Subject inclusion, displaying increased agitation. subject's mass increasing to dangerous levels. But it can be very beautiful too. That's why they are blobs. Oh yes. They wished for eternal life and bodies that would never decay. But the price was their minds and their physical bodies. Force applied has exceeded the cage containment limit. Please reactivate the restraining barrier. And it all goes down back to global warming fucking up the environment. People had to go underground and had to science. Eventually, they could not science anymore and found magic. And then they tried to science magic and everything went wrong. Warning, projected damage beyond manageable levels. Please reactivate the restraining barrier. Not good. Wutus, stop it now. At this rate, the Atari will break out into the city. Wutus. Wutus, you have to listen to me. Wutus. All of you, we need your master to come to his senses. Don't science magic, reverse engineer it. I yell at the Yatano Warabe, but they show no sign of having heard. Well, they did try to go around it, but eventually, you can't rely on Wutus. His mind is completely broken. He's not going to recover this. In that case, Wutus, give me the key. I close onto Wutus, take Master Key from the Yatano Warabe. Quickly move to block me. What are you doing? Do you not understand how dire our situation is? But they only stand there refusing to move, refusing to even acknowledge my words. God. So mankind is pretty much a thing. All you need is that key, yeah? Pretty much, there are survivors here and there, but right now in this room there are only two. In that case, Oki. Yes, our time has come. Stop. Now it's not time for us to fight. Then what do you propose we do? Damn. This kid has been scienced. As two sides face off, the tension is broken by a loud slap to the face. All of us freeze for a moment. We look towards the origin of sound. There we see. What? What exactly is? Wutus stares up, cowering before the one who slapped him. The boy only stands there silent and picks up the master key Wutus has dropped on the ground. Cheerio? Lord Wutus, you once told me that you wished to know how it felt to be betrayed by someone you trusted in. What? Oh, you. What have you done? Shichiria, have you lost your mind? The Yatano Warabe facing us all turn at once, surrounding Shichiria in seconds. However, Shichiria's face is impassive as he turns to them. And what of all of you? Is the loyalty you feel even real? Or is it an artificial impulse? A command planted within us for our own ends? For beings like us created by Lord Wutus? Are our hearts truly our own? That's right. That man, one of the clones of humanity, created an entire race of Shultas. And before all this madness happened, he was also a popular yaoi artist. Let that sink in. And will Lord Wutus ever return our loyalty? In the end, nothing truly bound us together. That? Don't listen to him. He sprouts nonsense. One of the Yatano Obaya jumps towards Shichiria and slices out. Shichiria does not fight back. He barely moves as the blade shears through him. Grizzly red soaks his chest. As he collapses on his back, he stares with a faint, bitter smile, his eyes cast skyward. Lord Raiko. I am so tired of this place. I wonder if you will be able to welcome a traitor like myself to your side once again. I know something bump against my foot and look down. Master Key, falling from Chiria's grasp. The confused Yatano Warabe quickly realized why the Master Key has gone, they turn on me. No time to hesitate. I seize the Master Key and raise it high above my head. Reactivate the barrier. Seal the Atari, now! Oh, the only answer we receive is... Unable to reactivate restraining barrier. What? Internal pressure has surpassed all limits. Cage boundaries have sustained critical damage. Contamination has been breached. Please begin emergency evacuation. Containment has been breached. Please begin emergency evacuation. Ah, fuck. Get away! Get away! Boss, they sound like they're making a racket up there. Excellent. Yeah, zero sounds that way. What the? Oh god, that's all of them. They're just expanding. Oh wait. It's the Tatari! Tatari of Koop! What are you just standing there for? But below us, there are still. Why do you care about the presence now of all times? Do you want to die? We need to learn around now. Well, because of the civil war, he was supposed to be executed, but because of the civil war, he was just held in prison indefinitely. They kind of forgot about him. Yes, sir. You know. Tatari. Holy f- hell. What? Aww, there's too many of the boss. Oh, those things. They're Tatari. What's going on? What are Tatari doing in the capital of all places? Understandable. Alright, boys, listen up. Change your plans. We're making a break for it. Now! Yes, boss. Wait, take me with you. You gotta help us. Please, I'm begging you. Don't leave me like this. Dumbasses. You think I'm gonna waste my time on that shit? Boss, we need to hurry. Boss, what's the matter? We gotta go. Tatari are coming. Okay, boys, scratch that. I want everyone looking through this place. Grab everything we can stack up for our barricade. We gotta buy some time. What, boss? You don't mean... Sure, we're all pieces of shit. I ain't gonna just leave him here to die. That ain't our way. Ain't that right, boys? Yes, boss. That's our boss. Sticking with the bitter end, boss. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, save the tanks till we get out of here with our dumb asses in one piece. Alright, boys. Hop to it. Aww. Yeah, wait, it's Chao Feng. Oh yeah, Chao Feng, the poor guy. He eventually got arrested, huh? The gate. Close the gate, quickly. We're trying. There's soldiers in front of the gates. Please, save us. No, I don't want to die like this. Let us out. Please, you gotta help us. Captain! Leave them. Close the gates now. If we don't, they'll devour us all. But... out of the way! You get out of the way. I'm going first. Wait, someone's on the ground. Stop, please! He's tired of me with Hajime. Do they? Do they deserve this? Oh, they got eaten. No use, we won't make it in. Well. How could this happen? The Imperial Capital is. It's all over! Rip Yamato. There you go, Yamato correct. The palace! The main street, the market street! The capital is being swallowed up? How could this be? Fucking Mikado. What can you do? To protect the image of the outside world show only carnage and chaos. Tartari swarm buildings that suit anyone in their path. Lutus, take me outside, now! How long are you gonna stay there gaping? Hurry up and take me to the capital. Damn it. It is very much his fault. Test and respond. I want damage projections. What happens if the Tatari go unchecked? Projecting damage and casualties possible by the code name Tatari. Tatari, under compression, are observed to grow expandingly large when it's called consumption of organic matter. Project the outcome. Subject's final expanded size will be 1,580 times the original. After absorbing all organic material nearby, the subjects will most likely move in search for more. Within one complete revolution of the planet, approximately 12% of Yamato will be consumed. Within 10 revolutions, 42% will be consumed. Well, by organic material, you mean people? People falls in the stated character category. Precisely defined, subjects will consume any living organism composed of substantial amounts of protein. Is there nothing we can do? Target has escaped the facility. Recovery of subjects is currently impossible. Elimination of subjects is currently impossible. Damn it. That's right, the Imperial Capital. The country of Yamato, well, do we have no options? Killing the Tatari is not impossible. Even if we freezing them slows them down, there's no way we can free something of that mass. We do have something. My brother mentioned it before, said there was only one way to destroy them. Brother said he'd given up on that method, but Wutis was trying to go through with it. Oh, it's time! This is it. The Particle Oscillation Wave Emitter emits the power force at specific frequency and deconstructs matter at an atomic level that should interrupt the regeneration end. Wait a minute. What kind of requirements are these? How much energy does this consume? Might have been possible we still had them locked in the ground, but now we literally have to drop a sun on them too. A sun? Oshitar? Yes, there is a way, of course. A sun. Bro, no, Mikado. Is it still up there? It? You don't mean to say... You intend on using it? But Tab would... I know. We have no other option. If we leave the tower like this, it won't just be the Imperial Capital. It will consume Yamato whole. We must end it before that happens. The Mikado falls silent. After a moment, he speaks again, voice low with regret. I suppose we have no choice. If the energy within the mausoleum is not enough, we'll have to look to an external energy source. However, if you use it, I must. If I must, I will carry that burden. I will be the man who destroys the Imperial Capital. Destroy the Imperial Capital? What are you talking about, Oshitar? Father? Yanju, do not blame Oshitar. It was I who could not let go of the past. I could not let go of them, even after they have changed into such hideous forms. And it was I who could not understand Utsu's feelings. The sin is mine. I am the one. Jesus, give Oshitar. I am the one to blame for all this. All of this was caused by my own weakness. I am the one who deserves your hate. I am the Mikado who brought Dengbokshiri upon the people he loved. Father, as everyone looked to me, I raised Masaki once more above my head. Open connections with Amaterasu. Oh, sure, is it Amaterasu? Authorization confirmed. Command accepted. Opening connections with Weather Control Satellite. Amaterasu. I'm worried spark a new image on the screen in front of me. Everyone, look. This is the night sky? What is that? A metal castle? That thing floating in the sky? Another relic of the Onviken Kaien, then. And a grand one. Change form. Deactivate weather control mode. And activate particle, oscillation wave, matter. Activation confirmed. Command accepted. Amaterasu, changing form. Oshitar, are you? The Tari are beings of no concept of death, but there is one way to end them, is to drop an artificial sun upon this earth, and use its energy to completely annihilate the Tari. This is the only option we have left. What? Annihilate? Sun? Wait, you mean to create a sun? Nodecraft. Truly, to craft a sun, even a miniature one, is no less than a work of the gods. But a sun? Is it truly safe to wield such power? If you were to drop a sun on this land, what of the Imperial Capital? I do not know. What do you mean? However, if we do not stop them here, the damage will quickly spread beyond the borders of the capital. Someone must end this. Utsu then has permission to activate the device in the mausoleum, so it's unlikely he'd be able to control Amaterasu. No, the only ones who can do this are the ones who can use the Master Key, so my brother and myself. But Auditory or not, do I still have the right to take the lives of everyone still in the Imperial Capital? No, I'll never have that right. Even still, I have to do it. The only problem that remains is... Glance over to the side where Wutus remains, dumbfounded and shocked. Need to go to bed? Alright, night, Jewelry! Thank you for being with us! Hopefully this was a nice little taste of what this game had to offer. Amaterasu wasn't intended as a weapon. Do I even have the authority to use it beyond the specs it's set to? See you later. Yes! Have a good sleep. I can hear my heart pounding. The command is rejected, our last hope is gone. I take a deep breath and declare my command aloud, my full heart in my throat. An introduction. Right, you showed up near like the end game of the third and last game. Oof. But hey, better late than ever, and I'm glad you popped in a very good, pretty good scene. Not the best. There are so many good scenes in this series. My god. But yes. Activate the particle oscillation wave emitter. But the terminal's voice remains silent. It's over. We're giving up, but Mikado suddenly speaks. Do not worry. Huh? Just as I turn towards the Mikado. Confirmed level 5 authorization clearance. Really? Activating particle oscillation wave emitter sequence. A small smile appears on the Mikado's face. You are the one and only success of the True Humanity Project. You embody humanity itself. The last to carry the name of the human race. So that's why. He was the one who that gave me. Particle oscillation wave emitter preparations complete. No targets designated. Please designate target and output level. Target will be all the Tauri in this area. Set output to maximum. Target confirmed. Maximum. All set frequency will automatically be adjusted to target oscillation signature. Warning, upon firing, all functions of Amaterasu will be shut down as a safety measure. Full system restart will be required, and what happens if all functions shut down? Until the system has been restarted, all meteorological regulation will cease. A long-term cold front will set in for all affected areas. The winter will come, but spring will never follow? User summary is correct. Yearly average temperature will drop to negative 15 Celsius. Yearly highs will reach 3 Celsius, and lows will reach negative 50 Celsius. That is far worse than I expected. Not a food protection area. Gun deployment. No, besides that, nobody will be prepared. Many will freeze to death. Can't even imagine how many casualties this will cause. But if I don't get rid of these things now, it'll end up the same. No one will survive. Does not matter. Command accepted. Releasing final safety measures. Transferring trigger timing to administrator. User may fire at will. Good. One last thing to confirm. This place. Will the underground facility of the mausoleum be able to withstand the blast? There's a 92% chance that the damage will affect this area. Well, I was hoping for better odds than that. Then what happens to those within this facility? Chance of survival for all within facility will be less than 1%. Just like that. Considering the scale of the blast, we think we will get out of this unscathed. Can Amaterasu be controlled from any other location? Remote command is only possible through specific portable terminals. What? What are those then? There are portable terminals registered with administrative revision. In order to use the terminal, re-authorization is necessary. Shit, do you think there's a chance? There is a chance. In order. Enough. Understood. Oh, sure. Kohan looks at me uneasily, which would mean that somebody has to stay here to control the firing process. No, not just anybody. I check it realizing. The only one who can fire is someone with administrative authority. With my brother in that state, that leaves me. Everyone, I want you to know, I will not allow Oshitor. Mikado. Anju seems to guess one thing and grab my sleeve or a hard expression. But my liege. I'm about to try to persuade Anju, but a solemn voice echoes from behind, interrupting me. Clearly. I am the right man for the job. I will take that responsibility. All of us turn to the speaker. He will be the one to pull the trigger. Oh, I'm gonna find. I have to believe we can about our voice. Brother. System, am I capable of triggering the firing process? User with administrator authorization may obtain fire command control with the head administrator's permission. Another thing, can it be fired without the master key? Permitted. Father? Anju's face pales in the Mikado's words. She clings desperately to the life pod. Your mother, father, you must come with us. Anju, where the hell do you think I'm going? I'm stuck to the life pod. This is much better than Oshitor sticking around. However, the Mikado gently shakes his head. I am no longer able to move from this spot. Even if I could move, I do not have much longer to live. But I could not bring myself to destroy that which I had created. My judgment was clouded. The responsibility is mine, Anju. Please. At least allow me to use what little life I have left to protect you. Please, Anju. This will be the first and last request I ask of you. Father. Anju crumples to the ground, tails welling up in her eyes. Oshitor, please protect my daughter. By your command. Miss Anju, my liege. But even if we are to escape, the outside is swarming with the Tauri. Can we even get out alive? Could we perhaps use the gate we passed through originally? Not possible. I want them to know. If I want to record it. Oh, real record? Many. I feel bad for Anju, not the Mikado. Ah, you could never like the man, huh? Fair enough. Many nearby locations have been compromised. It'd be too dangerous to reach that chamber. Yunichika, Mikazuchi, heed me well. I now issue my final imperial command. My liege. There's an emergency gate in the back. Its functions should be restored with the master key. It leads outside the imperial capital. I want you to take everyone. Take Anju to a safe location. As you command, even if I must give my life, I will carry out your will. I humbly accept your imperial command. Munichika and Mikazuchi both nod, then grab Anju and release her to her feet. No. I'm staying as well. Anju still struggles furiously, but the Mikado speaks softly, gentle reprimand. Anju, do you not have the role of leading this country? Leading the people? She doesn't have her mask. If she did, it would not be enough against the goddamn sun. I have absolute faith you are capable of leading Yamato without my help. Anju, from here on, the future of this country is in your hands. Daughter, do not cry. A smile suits you much better. Would you not allow me one last look at your smiling face? Oh man, she was turning people into bait. She could, but I would assume the energy expenditure of blocking out the sun might end up killing her, and it's just not worth. Father. Tears stream down Anju's face, but she fights through them, forcing a smile. Thank you, Anju. Now, go. Anju gives a small nod and heads to the exit led by Munichika, staring back longingly as she leaves her father behind. The father follows, surrounding her protectively. Kuon, bringing up the rear, calls urgently to me. Oshita, hurry! Go on ahead. But I will be there shortly. Let the others know. My response clearly makes Kuon uneasy, but she follows after Anju, leaving the room. After I see Kuon's left the room, I look back at my brother, trapped in his transparent casket. My mom swims. For a moment, I think of the past and everything that's happened since I awoke. But we don't have much time to dwell on it, and I can't stay here for much longer. System. Transfer. Firing authorization. Authorization transferred. Goodbye, bro. I'm glad I got to see you again. As am I. My words get one last smile from him. If he didn't, Oshitori and Mikado will die for her. Let's relax and let the fun take you. Hanukkah, good reason. I'm either way, Hanukkah. I look towards Hanukkah who stands next to the life pod. But she says nothing. She only meets my eyes with a kind smile. I realize what she means by it. I bow in response and turn away from them. Oshita, hurry! Everyone waiting in front of the activate gate. You were waiting for me? There's no way I'll leave you behind, brother. Turns out we were all thinking the same thing. Better is not, as it's the obvious conclusion. Thank you. Talk later. The gate is functional now, but we must hurry. At twin's words, I looked at the gate. Ball of rippling light as he gained the morph and destroyed in the shape of the gate. The emergency gate. Looks like we don't have time to worry about where we're going. Everyone jump in! On my cue, one by one, we all jump into the gate. We gotta leave you. Oshitar. My liege, please hurry. I will not go. I will not go. How can I leave my father behind again? Anju breaks free of Munichika's grasp. Munichika loses her balance and sudden push and is sucked in the blind lane of the gate. At the same time, I hear the ringing tone of the tuning fork, and the very air in the room seems in trouble. Is this gate destabilizing? Father! There is no time. I grab the struggling Anju and leap into the gate with her. With no idea what awaits on the other side. After watching his little brother leave, the Mikado looks to his fallen son, still slumped on the ground, near Katatonic. Mutus. He calls to him, but there's no response. Mutus merely continues to mumble to himself. Finally, the Mikado calls out to the Yatanawabe. watching Wootus from a short distance away. Oh, wait. Yeah, you there. Wootus is like, what? Yeah, Wootus is broken. You there. If you will not go with Oshitor, I suggest you use the shelter in the depths of the facility. I cannot guarantee absolute safety from Amaterasu, but... please, save my foolish son. At that, the Yatano Owabe seem to come to their senses. They look at each other and then nod. With Wootus limp as a doll, they haul him up and then run to a different door than the one used by Koan and others. At last, only the Mikado and Hanako remain. Well, I suppose we're the only ones left. It seems pleasant enough to me. We've both been so busy these days. It's been hard to find little moments like these to spend together. I suppose that's true. Intrusion detected in blocks A and B, clothing bulkheads. Bulkhead sexual integrity has been compromised. Unfortunately, seems we do not have the time to be sentimental. Hanako has chosen to go with, my lord. It appears that this will be the last chance we have to speak like this. So, there's one question I must ask before it all ends. I knew. Through the years, the centuries, I knew I would have to ask you this one day. Yet I could not muster the courage until now. And would that be? Do you resent me for what I've done? Wootus was right. For the sake of soothing my own heart, I toyed with life itself. I created you. The duty I've given you is nothing more than an excuse, so that I may have you by my side. In the end, the emotion you feel towards me are little other than hard-coded directives I've forced into your mind. I cannot let go of the past. Everything I've accomplished is a farce, a way for me to avert my eyes from the life I left behind. But you have a heart of your own, just as Wootus does, just as the Yatana Warabe do. I feared that you doubted your own heart due to your origin. This will be the end. If you hold any hatred towards me, I ask you tell me now. I would understand. After a short silence, Hanako smiled sadly. If she truly hated you, my dude, she would not be here. Yes. Perhaps there was a time when I did resent you, deep in my heart. As I die. Yet, even if the emotions in my heart of mine were engraved by your own hand, it is the only heart I have. Even if I could not say why I loved you, I accepted those feelings and lived by them. And after a long, long time, new emotions, my emotions, began to form over the compulsions I first knew. If there is one thing I regretted, it is that you have never spoken words of love to me yourself. It was truly disheartening. Even with all my love, it never seemed as though my emotions could reach you. A tear runs down Hanako's cheek. All because he was a freaking coward. If only expressed my love for you more, then maybe. Hanako, I... my lord Mikado, did you never love me? No, why? Of course I did. I have always loved you. Always. Mikado weakly presses his hand against the glass, and Hanaka softly moves to join him, palm to palm, separated by the clear wall between them. Hanaka, my lord. Good. Splendid. At last, I have no more regrets in this world. I was truly blind over these long centuries I have lived. I'm sorry that you must accompany me even now, into the very end. Not at all. When we go together. That was my one and only wish. Yes, this time, we go together. Hanaka nods gently. When next we meet, you shall be my wife. With all my heart. Amaterasu. Fire. Not a bad scene at all. Ah. Sad they both gotta go. But you hate his guts, my man. Even though, I don't know, I feel like he is truly the humanist character here. In terms of flaws, like, he embodies all of humanity's flaws. Poor guy. If he didn't go with the... If he didn't go with the Hanaka. Ah, they come with a set, after all. When we arrive, we are greeted with an otherwise empty room. Yeah, I can look at that. All I can hear is everyone breathing and a faint noise with the machine. The main power source for the teleportation seems to have given out, but it looks like we're all made to okay. But where is this? It looks like we're some kind of building. Anju's voice suddenly reverberates through the room. Father. Ukitor, where is Father? My liege. None of us can answer her question. Father! Rushes to the wall in search of an exit. A portion of the wall automatically begins shifting as in response to Anju's presence, revealing a telltale crack in the middle. Father! Anju pushes open the door and rushes out the room. My liege, you can't run off on your own. It could be dangerous, Miss Anju! Alarmed, we all rush after her, chase after the footsteps we hear from above, eventually leading to a spiral staircase that winds upward. Suddenly, our view opens up. Appears though we arrived atop a high tower. Treetops spread out before us, our vantage point high enough to see a distance away. This place is. As I look around trying to figure out where we are, blinding light flashes across the sky. To our very eyes, a spear of light falls from the heavens, piercing down on a point on the distant horizon. In an instant, a shockwave ripples through the air. Oh, that must be where the Imperial Kato is. What the? It was a huge pillar of light. The cleansing light. It was like a pillar that connected the earth and the heavens. It has to have been the Ama thing you were talking about. Oh no, that means everything beneath it is. Bro, Amaterasu luckily doing exactly what we told it to. Annihilating all the Tari, investing the Imperial Capital. Would have been a mystical sight if I didn't know it was happening by the end of that light. Oh. My leash. Father. Tears run freely down her face, no longer caring to hold them back. Anju clings to Munichika, sobbing openly. None of us know how to comfort her. All we can do is stand there in silence. And now winter will come. Time gradually goes by, we start to feel the bite of the cold night wind. Shoot. Akune sneezes, brings us to our senses. We can't stay here forever. We have to set up camp. Exhausted by her sobbing, Anju seems to have worn herself out. So she now rests limply against Minajika Fest, and surely Oshito can do. Small consolation, but that's all we have. The Colon takes command in setting up the camp. Her directions are quick and precise, and we all get busy with ourselves about duties. Mikazuchi and the twins are given the duty of keeping watch. Jack Ward and Uyu on firewood duty. No three, Kiru Hatui, in charge of finding food. Minajika, will you stay beside her, don't you? Understood. Nekone, Rufte, will you help me get ready to cook? Understood. Yeah, we shall have. That would be better. Yeah, we shall have one for you. Yes? Yes, I'll get the fire started immediately. In that case, I'll help as well. If we take too long, the sun's gonna set on us. We better get a move on. Koan claps her hands. We're hurrying us along. Koan, what should I do? Could you go and get us some water? There should be a river if you follow along this road. Understood. Will you help me then, Kokopo? Kokopo. I followed Koan's path, and sure enough, I found a small river after some walking. I filled the letter canteen full of water, and then stacked it on Kokopo's back. I'm surprised she knew there was a river here. I turned back, and about to head to the campsite when I see something extending into the sky. It's that. Back at our arrival point, I see a spire towering the evening sky. It looks out of place, like it doesn't belong in this world. Some kind of tower. Alright, I need to hurry up and get this water back for everyone. Oh. Our tent is eventually ready, and our meal is soon after. Wild game of the mountains, fish, and some wild vegetables are set out before us. Looks like it turned out quite a feast. It's like a good old pop dinner. I'm glad we have some amon powder and salt on hand. Indeed, truly appetizing. Just the scent of it makes my mouth water. Yes, Miss Nekone found some herbs along the way. If we all eat together chatting about the taste, Anju alone remains completely silent. She does not touch her food. You ought to have some food, I think. I'm not hungry. I'm not taking no for an answer. She thrusts an amanui towards Anju. Just give it a try. I find lots of things are less distressing on a full stomach. For real, stop laughing and help me get Anju to have some. Oh, just thinking that sentiment needs more coming from you. Fumio's observation sent a chuckle through the group. They're all trying to help, both my liege and I. If you will not take it, my liege, then shall I shall have something instead.